The age of innocence was when Adam and Eve was upon the earth. And this age was also an age where Satan was upon the earth. But when Satan was there, he needed a window of opportunity because he seen something pure. He seen something holy. He seen God communing with Adam and Eve. But Adam was the man of God. He couldn't get to Adam. But he needed to get access because he was thrown from heaven. He needed to something to corrupt. Like we said before, there's no truer statement than misery loves company. So when man arrived on the scene, imagine a brief satisfaction it gave to Satan. So it's just like today, evil can be all around us. Amen. They could be saying anything, they could be doing curses or whatever, but that evil tries to seek to try to get into your life, to corrupt you. And so it doesn't tell you how long that the devil tried or how long it took him to get to them, but he finally got to them. So evil seems to be all around. You can't stop the birds from flying, but you can prevent them from building a nest upon your hair. Now we see that when they go further in the book of Genesis, we see that God said his name was I Am. And this was at the time when he first called Moses. And then later, when he was giving them the Ten Commandments, he said, jealous. My name is jealous. So that leads me to think that his name is I Am Jealous. I am jealous. God don't want anybody else. He don't want you to worship anybody else. That's all you need to know. Yes. And to the worldly mind, that may throw you off. Why would God call himself jealous? You know, we so carnal, we try to figure it out. But that's what he said. He said he's jealous. Yeah. Amen. He's not hateful. Yeah. He don't have a human characteristic. He said, my name is jealous. I am jealous. Yeah. So without all contradiction, the less is blessed by the better. So we are less. We are blessed by God. Amen. So we need to figure out how could we not let sin enter our lives. We need to keep the devil outside of our life. And we know that God came to provide redemption for us. And once we receive this redemption, we need to keep it. Because we know it's a possible thing of losing your redemption. Look at Judas. He was selected by Jesus as one of the disciples, but he ended up losing his place, and he had to select another. So we need to keep our salvation. We need to keep our election sure. Because we know that Satan was cast to the earth, and we know that he's around now. And we know that sometimes when God may point Satan to you to say, consider my servant. So you always need to be able to fend off the enemy. Now, the Bible says that when in Revelation 12, when he was cast out of the earth, he said that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they love their lives not unto the death. So the way you keep the devil out is not losing your testimony. Amen. And you need the blood of Jesus, because that's how you overcome. And many times it may look like you're losing. And many times you may look at number. Many times you may look at see the things the way the world sees them. You know, the world tries to keep you in a mind of fear. tries to keep your imagination full of fear. Look at the news and everywhere you turn, and I just think they just do it to keep you in fear, because when you're in fear, then you're not in faith. And you need to please God. The world's not caring about you pleasing God. They just want you worried. They just want you worried about your bills and worried about the election and worried about the president and worried about Kosovo and worried about all these other countries and worried about reparations and all these other things. But God said he shall supply all your needs. Amen. We need to focus on Christ. Because once we focus on God, the devil has a hard time getting in. That's why Satan had a hard time fooling Adam. He couldn't fool Adam because God gave Adam the commandment. Amen? So we know that Satan comes in. He may come in. He may try to come in. But if he tries to come in, we got to kick him out. Amen? And if you have a lapse of judgment, that's okay. Because we all fall short at one point in our life. We all have a lapse of judgment. We all do something that we regret. But you know what we need to do? We need to clean up. We need to not go down that same road. Amen?
Yes.
We need to change our direction and move toward God. Because the outlaw who was banished from heaven and thrust upon the earth is still active today. But his time is coming to an end. See, the devil has a sentence. And his sentence is almost up. But as for us, when we die, we go back to God. Or we may just be like Enoch, or we may be raptured out of here. But don't you want to spend your time on earth and then go back to see God in peace? We want to go back and see God in peace. That's what I want to do.
Yes.
So, when God created the heaven and the earth and became without form and void, we know that that void came from the fall. Because God says, so my word shall not go forth out of my mouth and shall not return unto me void. But the earth was out form and void. Don't you know that spiritual things can cause natural deformities? Something can look deformed due to a spiritual result. They got a place on earth, I think it's called the Marianas Fault. They say it's miles and miles deep in the ocean. We don't know where Satan impacted the earth, but I like to think that his impact on the earth caused the earth a catastrophic event that caused the floods and darkness and everything out of order. God's not a God of disorder. He's a God of order. And anything that causes confusion is not of God. So we need to order our lives and order our steps in the way that God chose us to walk. Amen? So creation is something we need to believe in. Even though they took creation out to schools and start teaching evolution and all these other things, we need to raise up our children and raise up the ones that we love in the admonition of the Lord, according to the Holy Scripture. Because sometimes the state is off. Many times the state is off. You know, they just changed their mind about abortion. But they went 50 years endorsement killing babies. So 50 years of killing babies, don't you know those babies are under the altar crying for revenge? Somebody got to pay for that innocent blood. They said Abel's blood cried from the ground. It had a voice. See, blood has a voice. Because the Bible said that life is in the blood. And an unborn baby has blood. Has a heartbeat. So what's going to happen? What's going to happen? I tell you. I pity the person who endorses something that God calls an abomination. Because if God called it an abomination, it's an abomination. You got a choice to serve God or not. So I wouldn't want to be on the wrong side. Amen? When the judgment comes down. So we just thank God. We took you back to the garden very briefly. We thank God for this time that we give to honor him with his word.